Hello everyone, this is Sheetal Trivedi, Assistant Professor from the Department of Pharmaceutical Technology. Welcome to the MOOC series, an initiative taken by LG Institute of Pharmacy Ahmedabad. In this video, we will see about chemical incompatibility. So what is chemical incompatibility? This can be referred as undesirable changes that occurs on mixing the formulation ingredients which are antagonistic in nature because of their chemical properties. And these undesired changes may affect the safety and therapeutic purpose of the drug product, or it may change the appearance of the drug product. So what are the chemical reactions that are responsible for the chemical incompatibility? So the chemical reactions like change in pH, then redox reaction, acid base hydrolysis, then isomerization, polymerization, then decarboxylation, carbon dioxide absorption, complexation, this type of chemical reactions, because of the chemical nature of the ingredients present in the formulation, responsible for the incompatibility, and this may result into visible changes or non-visible changes like precipitation, effervescence, color change, explosion, and decomposition or degradation of the product. For example, aspirin that undergoes hydrolysis in presence of the aqueous medium into salicylic acid and acetic acid. Okay, let's see about the drugs which undergo oxidation. For example, vitamin C tablet, right, which act as antioxidant but gets oxidized in presence of the oxygen. So we may find the discoloration or the color change in the vitamin C tablet if it is being exposed to the environment. So when oxidative reactions are responsible for drug degradation, what can be the remedy or how we can minimize the oxidative reaction? So for this, antioxidants can be added into the formulation, and we know that the metal ions potentiate the oxidative reaction. So chelating agent can be added into the formulation that will make complex with the free metal ions and will minimize the oxidative reaction. pH can also be maintained to minimize the oxidative reaction. We know that the temperature is responsible for the higher rate of reaction. So storing the product at low temperature will minimize the rate of reaction. Rate of reaction is also higher in case of the product in liquid state compared to the solid state. So conversion of the liquid formulation into the solid formulation can also minimize this problem. The space above the product in the container can also be replaced by the nitrogen, and that will prevent the oxidation of the product. If light is responsible for the oxidation, that is, if the drugs undergo photooxidation, then product must be protected from the light exposure. So for this, the labeling condition can be mentioned to keep the product away from the direct sunlight, or it need to be stored in dark place, or the light absorbing components or the substance can be added into the product. So these are the ways we can minimize or we can correct the chemical incompatibility because of this oxidative chemical reaction. When hydrolysis is responsible for the drug degradation, like in aspirin, how we can minimize hydrolysis or the remedies to minimize this kind of chemical reaction? So for this, moisture absorbent can be added into the formulation. Now most of the time pH is responsible for the hydrolytic degradation, so buffers are added to maintain the pH. Obviously the temperature is responsible for the higher rate of reaction. So storing the product at low temperature will minimize the hydrolytic degradation, and the hydrolysis that is due to the aqueous medium. So replacing this aqueous system with a suitable solvent system will also minimize the hydrolytic degradation. Hydrolytic degradations are also at high rate in case of solution. So converting solution into suspension kind of dosage form will minimize the solubility of the drug that is undergoing hydrolytic degradation and will minimize the hydrolysis. And further, stability can be improved by converting the liquid dosage form into the solid dosage form. Complexing agents can also be added to minimize the free drug that is available to undergo the hydrolysis. And for this kind of moisture sensitive drug, manufacturing is also need to be done under the lower humidity environment, and the products are also need to be protected from the air humidity. And for this reasons, the product must be stored in moisture proof container and it must be stored in dry place. So these are the ways to minimize the hydrolytic degradation. Let's see about the types of chemical incompatibilities. Now, earlier there was an era of extemporaneous compounding and dispensing, but nowadays we know that the ready-made unidose formulations are being sold at the chemist and druggist shop. So nowadays the formulation pharmacist must be aware about the chemical properties of the ingredients involved in the formulation. So based on method of rectification, these are of two types, one that is tolerated incompatibility and the another that is adjusted incompatibility. So what is done in tolerated incompatibility? Here the problem is solved by changing the order of mixing or by changing the process without changing the ingredients of the formulation or the prescription. So that is called tolerated incompatibility. And in case of adjusted incompatibility, here the problem is solved by either adding or substituting or by deleting any of the formulation ingredient without affecting the therapeutic value of the product. Based on the speed of the reaction rate, chemical incompatibility can be divided into category. One that is called immediate chemical incompatibility and the another one that is delayed chemical incompatibility. Now what happens in immediate chemical incompatibility? Whenever we mix the formulation ingredients, it immediately results into the chemical incompatibility. Whereas in delayed incompatibility, whenever we mix the formulation ingredient, the reaction rate is very slow and that's why we don't find any immediate changes, but it happens when we store the product for a long period of time and that may result into the visible changes. Based on the intention of the prescriber, chemical incompatibility can be intentional one or unintentional one. So when prescriber intentionally prescribe the chemically incompatible drugs, that is called intentional one, and when prescriber unknowingly prescribe the chemically incompatible drugs, that is called unintentional chemical incompatibilities. So that is about the type of chemical incompatibilities. Let's see about the precipitation yielding chemical incompatibility. Well, precipitation can occur because of the physical properties or chemical properties. So here I have taken the example of chemical incompatibility. For example, alkaloidal salts, for example, strychnine hydrochloride, right? Alkaloids are the specific group of the molecules that is obtained from the plants. So alkaloidal salts, when mixed with the alkaline substance, for example, aromatic spirit of ammonia. So what happens? This results into the conversion of the salt form into the alkaloidal base form. And the solubility is different for alkaloidal base and alkaloidal salts. So alkaloidal salts are having more solubility compared to the base. So this may result into the precipitation of the alkaloidal base. Now this will depend on the solubility of the alkaloidal base that is formed and the total amount of the product or the solvent system that is present. So based on that, it may result into the precipitation. And if the precipitation occurs, again the precipitates can be of two type, one that is diffusible one and the another that is indiffusible one. So when precipitates are diffusible in nature, it won't pose much problem. We can solve this problem by modifying the procedure. And whenever the precipitates are indiffusible in nature, it requires addition of the suspending agent that will help in distributing this indiffusible precipitates. So what is the method? Method A and method B that is used to correct the precipitation yielding chemical incompatibility. So what is done in method A? In this method, the total solvent that is involved in product or the preparation is divided in two equal parts and the two reacting substances are dissolved separately into these two parts, and then one solution is added slowly into the another solution with constant stirring. So this will result into the minimization of the precipitation and it will also result into very fine precipitate that can be uniformly distributed throughout the product. And what is done in method B? Here total solvent is divided into two parts, and in one part one reacting substance is dissolved and the other portion of the solvent is taken in water, and into this 2% of the CPT, that is compound powder of tragacanth or any suitable suspending agent, that is to be added, and the mucilage is to be prepared with constant stirring, right? And then the first solution, that is to be added into this mucilage with constant fracturation. So this will result into the uniform distribution of the indiffusible kind of precipitates. So let's see a few more examples related to chemical incompatibility. And in case of alkaloidal incompatibility, we know that the alkaloidal salts are having interaction with the alkaline substances, but these alkaloidal salts are also having interaction with the soluble iodides, tannins, then soluble bromides and soluble salicylates. And this chemical incompatibilities can also be advantages in some cases. So here we can see that when tannins are there in formulation along with the alkaloidal salts, it will result into alkaloidal tannates, and these tannates are having lower solubility compared to the alkaloidal salts, and this chemical reaction can be exploited as benefit in treating alkaloidal poisoning with tannin. Okay, let's see another example of alkaloidal incompatibility, and that is also an example of adjusted incompatibility. So here you can see this formulation or the prescription includes sodium salicylate and caffeine citrate, and that is to be formulated in form of mixture by adding the purified water. So look at the quantity of caffeine citrate. Now what happens whenever we mix the formulation ingredient, the caffeine citrate, the citric acid part of the caffeine citrate convert the sodium salicylate into the salicylic acid, and this salicylic acid is having poor solubility and that will result into the precipitation. So how we can eliminate this problem? Well, caffeine citrate, that is the mixture of the equal parts of caffeine and citric acid. So in this case we can substitute this caffeine citrate with half quantity. So right now the quantity, that is 0.650 gram, that is of caffeine citrate. So instead of adding this quantity of caffeine citrate, it can be substituted by adding 0.325 gram of caffeine. So this will eliminate the problem of precipitation of the salicylic acid, and this won't affect the therapeutic value of the product. So this is the example of adjusted incompatibility. Let's see another example of the chemical incompatibility, which is delayed type of incompatibility, and that also results into the color change. So here in this prescription or formulation, you can see the ingredients, that is quinine sulfate, dilute sulfuric acid, which is used to solubilize the quinine sulfate. It also includes potassium iodide, and formulation need to be converted into the mixture. So what happens in this case, whenever we prepare this product, initially there is a clear solution, but when product is stored for more than 3 days, it results into the deposition of the bronze color scale over the surface of the product container, right? So because of the delayed chemical reaction, this is the example of delayed chemical incompatibility. So what can be the remedy? Either the product is required to be dispensed in a dose that can be consumed within 3 days, or the potassium iodide or quinine sulfate and sulfuric acid can be dispensed separately. This chemical reaction is also called herapatite reaction because of the formation of the crystal of iodoquinine sulfate, and this interaction is beneficial to analyze the quinine in the quinine tablet, and this interaction is intentionally used to produce the herapatite crystals. Let's see about the chemical incompatibility that results into the effervescence of the carbon dioxide. So whenever the acidic components are mixed with the bicarbonate or the carbonate, it will result into the formation of the carbon dioxide. So whenever this type of chemical reactions are involved, the product must be packed after completion of the effervescence. So these were the few examples to understand the concept of chemical incompatibility. These are the references. Thank you so much for watching this video.